Hello, my name is Jonas. In this video, I will show you how to generate MaxCLL and MaxFALL metadata using HDR10+ in DaVinci Resolve. If you haven't seen my previous videos about how to create HDR video, I suggest you check out my playlist called How to Create HDR Video. Those tutorials will give you all the information you need to get started with creating high dynamic range video. So, let's begin. Metadata is information about the content, in this case the video, and it's meant to solve the problem where consumer displays have different capabilities than the source grading monitor, a problem specific to HDR video. Metadata allows the display to adjust the brightness and colors of the content to match its own limitations. MaxCLL and MaxFALL is static metadata, meaning that it doesn't change over the course of the program. And together with ST2086, which is mastering display information, is part of the HDR10 standard. Maximum content light level, or MaxCLL, refers to a single brightest pixel in an entire video. And maximum frame average light level, or MaxFALL, refers to the frame with the highest average brightness in an entire video. Both these values are presented in nits. I've done a test where I uploaded a video to YouTube, both with and without these parameters. And as you can see in this footage shot to my LG C7, the video containing MaxCLL and MaxFALL metadata has a slightly higher peak brightness than a video without. Before showing you how to generate this metadata, I want to briefly talk about MaxFALL and how it relates to ABL, the automatic brightness limiting of a display. Pretty much all HDR displays available today can only show a limited amount of its peak brightness on all the pixels at the same time. This is known as the MaxFALL value of the display, the maximum frame average light level it can produce. A good way to visualize MaxFALL is to imagine a gray image. Here I've adjusted a white solid to sit at 81 nits, which is the MaxFALL value of this particular shot. When the maximum frame average light level of a display is exceeded, meaning that the overall brightness becomes too high, ABL kicks in and dims the whole screen. I believe this function was created because of two reasons. Firstly, to protect the display from heat, and secondly, to comply with legal requirements regarding power consumption. Anyway, this is something colorists and content creators have to be aware of, both when shooting for HDR and when grading in HDR. Although I believe this limitation will be less of a consideration in the future with new display technologies. To generate MaxCLL and MaxFALL metadata, I will use HDR10+ to analyze the footage in DaVinci Resolve. This has to be done in the original project, where the HDR video was graded. I tried analyzing the rendered video in a separate project, but the numbers I get doesn't make sense. So, when you're finished with your HDR grade, go into Project Settings, Color Management, and activate HDR10+. You can now see that this HDR10+ tab now is available. To generate the metadata, we need to analyze the clips. Go to Color, HDR10+, and choose Analyze All Shots. This process might take a short while to finish. Once it's done, you need to export your video to get the metadata. Except for choosing your video settings, be sure to check Export HDR10 metadata. This will give you a separate file that contains the MaxCLL and MaxFALL values. You can also embed these values into the video if you want to. Also, make sure that tone mapping is set to none to not include any changes the HDR10+ analysis might have made to the grade. After the export, you will find this document which contains the metadata. Change its file format to, for example, .txt to be able to read it. Here you can see the values for the actual clip presented on a separate row for each individual frame. To the right, you have the MaxCLL and MaxFALL values. These change over the course of analysis as new maximum values appear. So, to get the final values, you have to scroll down to the bottom of the document, and there you'll find the relevant data. In another video, I'll show you how to add these values as metadata to your video before uploading it to YouTube. If you have thoughts or questions, please leave a comment below. Also, remember to like and subscribe for videos. Thanks for watching, until next time, goodbye.